kugira gyeje.
If others are succeeding, you can succeed. If others are making it, you can also make it. If others are succeeding spiritually, you can also succeed. If others are making it big time and succeeding financially, materially, you can also make it. If you can try, you can do it. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. I bless your name this day. It is an opportunity to share your word again on this very important subject. Dear Lord and Father, I pray that the Holy Spirit of God will come into the church. Lord, you will take over the message and give your people the message you want your people to hear. Dear Lord and Father, glorify yourself. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Welcome to church.
Regain
your seats. You know, away from the holiness preaching, the Bible says we should be balanced. And you feed a child only with cassava. The child is going to develop koshaku. And you feed the child only with beans.
Meat.
Well, before you discover, the child will not be able to walk. The legs will be paining, arthritis. The big stomach will become pregnant. But when you are feeding children, you are making sure they are taking a bit of protein.
Some minerals.
All the different classes of food. So it is in the church of God. The word of God is in compartments. It has different subjects. And you must feed the church if you want the church to grow. You want the church to be balanced and strong. The church should be spiritually strong, materially strong, financially strong. If you have a church that they are all spiritual human beings, Lazarus Church. The church of Lazarus. Everybody. This one cannot eat, have food to eat. This one is sick. He cannot go to hospital. There is no money. That is not a church. The Bible says, rightly dividing the word of truth. So today. I say so today.
No, you must be COVID.
I'm going to talk on a different subject. I will be talking about believers' faithfulness during economic crisis. Believers. Faithfulness during economic crisis. As we live in this world, we should know and we should understand
that
there are difficult moments, there are difficult times, there are difficult situations. There are things that will happen that we are not expecting. There are situations that might come in your family that you were not expecting. And you begin to run from pillar to pole. You begin to knock the doors of neighbors and neighbors cannot sleep. You begin to blame other people because they are not helping you. You start bringing witchcraft in the family. Envy and jealousy will come into your heart. My uncle is rich, he's not helping me.
Look at that,
my brother that is US, he's not sending me money. You begin to think, I have a brother in Congo. You know, when you have problems and you are not able to solve your problems, your problems become other people's problems. You begin to suffer other families because of your problems. So, as a church, as a Christian, there are things that you must know. There are things that you must do. Let's go to the scripture. Let me read you a situation that happened in the Bible. In 2 Kings,
2
Kings is a pathetic situation. You will listen very carefully. 2 Kings chapter 6, I'm reading from verse 25. Hear what the Bible says. And there was a great famine in Samaria, and behold, they besieged it until the ass head was sold for 80 pieces of silver, and the fourth part of a calf dove dung for 5 pieces of silver. And as the king of Israel was passing by upon the wall, there cried a woman unto him, saying, "Help, my Lord, help, O king!" And he said, "If the Lord cannot help thee, whence shall I help thee? Out of the barn floor, or out of the wine press?" And the king said unto her, "What alas thou?" And she said, and she answered, "This woman said unto me, Give me thy son, so that we may eat him today, and I will eat, and we will eat my son tomorrow. So we boiled my son, and we did eat him. And I said unto her, On the next day, give thy son, that we may eat him. And he has hid his son." And it came to pass, when the king heard these words of the woman, that she rent her clothes, and he passed on the wall. And the people looked, and behold, he had sackcloth within upon his flesh.
Ndetse kugeza ako baguriye igihanga cy'indogobe ibice by'ifeza 80 n'igice cyakane cyagakondwe kamwe k'amahurunguru y'inuma ibice by'ifeza 5. Gutya umwami w'Abisirayeli anyuze hejuru y'inkike z'amabuye, umugore aramutakambira ati, "Ndengera nyagasani mwami." Aramusubiza ati, "Uwiteka natakurengera, ibyo kurengera ndabikura he? Ndabikura ku mbuga cyangwa mu rwengero?" Umwami aramubaza ati, "Ubaye ute?" Aramusubiza ati, "Uyu mugore yarambwiye ati, Zana umwana wawe w'umuhungu tumurye none, ejo tuzajye iwawe uwanjye. Nuko duteka umwana wanjye turamurya." Bukeye bwaho ndamubwira nti, "Zana umwana wawe tumurye," none yamwishe.
There was great famine in Samaria.
How are you that bitch in Samaria?
Church, look up. The famine became so serious. Food got finished. Nobody had food to eat.
Now, they
resulted in eating their own children. Then I have to go to your family. Neighbor, let us bring your own child. We cook your own child and eat today.
We must try to away.
Then we manage for today.
We must try to go to
I will bring my own child.
Then
we will come and we
will
eat. So a situation happened that the woman has discussed with the neighbor.
That
is in my own church today. And tomorrow,
we
are going to eat your own. But the next day, the woman said, bring that child, let us kill and eat. The woman took the child and hid the child. And the woman was crying. As he saw the king, he said, King, help.
Look
this situation. Come and intervene. This woman,
we
had my child yesterday. Today is hiding his
home.
He shouldn't bring and we eat. Let me tell you, these are things that happen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It might never come to this point. Something happened in Cameroon. A woman killed the first child. I'm talking of cut into pieces and cook. He cooked that child, waiting to eat. While that one was still there, the other one was still alive. He called the other one to kill also. Somebody intervened. If somebody reached the point that he killed his own child, cook his own child, and eat his own child, you know what it means. What they say is this: there are situations that can happen. We don't know what this world is up to. This world is going to an end.
Things
will become more difficult. Things are going to come.
Were
we expecting the pandemic COVID-19? Were we expecting? Did we know something was going to happen? But something has happened. People have lost their jobs. Families are suffering. People are crying. But now, as a child of God, you need to be wise. You need to think ahead. You need to plan your life. You need to know where you are going to be. You need to program for your family. You need to think about your children. Not just the kind of people we have today. If they have money today, they eat it and finish. And any salary, the money is, the month has died. When the month finishes, I collect my salary. I finish. I'm waiting for the next month. When the next month comes, I collect it. I finish it. By the way, next month is still coming. Let me tell you, you can lose that job. If you lost that job, where are you going to go? You're not planning for your future. You're not planning for your family. You are 40 years. There is nothing you can show for. You are 50 years. There is nothing you can show for. No house. No money. Nothing. Where are you going to? Where are you leading the family to? You are 60 years. Your hair is all white. Children are sitting all around you. You cannot educate children. To those whose children are this small. When they look at them, my children are this small. These children that are small. What are you planning for them? What are you thinking about their future? Hallelujah. How many jobs can Rwandan government provide for
Rwandans?
Can the government of Rwanda give jobs to all of us? You know, when you are not planning your life, the next thing that is going to happen
to
is that you will carry your problems and put on the government. You
will
carry your problem and put on the state.
There
are no jobs. They are not providing us jobs. We don't have jobs. I am poor. I'm going to point you out some things today.
Hallelujah.
And this is the church I pastor. I said, we'll point out some things to you.
And
we will rise up from this church and start doing something with your life. ubuzima
bwawe
umubiri
iyo
ni inzara y'ubuzima
bw'umubiri
hari n'inzara yo kujya kumwuka hari inzara y'ijambo ry'Imana muri iki
gihugu people are looking for the truth people are searching for a church is it that there are no churches
ese nuko nta matoro ahari
is it that there are no churches
nuko nta matoro ahari ra
churches are everywhere
amatoro ahantu hose
the people are searching for the truth
ariko abantu bashakukuri
because the truth is missing
kuko kuri kurabuze
they don't know where to see the truth
ni baza bazo
kuri they go to this church
bajya muri itorero
they listen
bagatega amatwi
I'm not sure what I'm looking for. If it is music, I will get it from another church.
I will
not go to another church. If it enters that church,
you
listen. No.
Oh, yeah.
It's not the place.
I
will go to another place. Let me read to you the Bible. In the book of Amos. Because if I say for my mouth, you will not know. As Christians, we should know and understand. Let me read from the Bible.
Amos,
chapter 8. Chapter 8 from verse number 11. Chapter 8, verse 11. There is hunger for the truth in the land. Verse 11. Behold, the day cometh. That was a prophecy. The day cometh, saith the Lord, that I will send a famine in the land. Not a famine for bread, nor thirst for water, but the famine of hearing the word of the Lord. And they shall wander from sea to sea, and from the north even to the east. And they shall run to and fro, seeking for what? Seek to seek the word of the Lord, and they shall not find it.
Amosi, ibice umunani, guhera ku wa 11, dore iminsi izaza, nibwo Uwiteka Imana ivuga, nzateza inzara mu gihugu, nizaba ari inzara yo kurya cyangwa inyota yo gushaka amazi, ahubwo izaba ari iyo kumva amagambo y'Uwiteka, kandi bazajarajara bava ku nyanja imwe bajya ku yindi, bazava ikasikasi bagere iburasirazuba, bazakubita hirya no hino, bashaka iki, bashaka ijambo ry'Uwiteka.
The Lord told
Amos.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord told Amos.
But
hold on.
It waits.
A day is coming. I will send a famine upon the land. Because people don't want to hear the truth. People don't want to believe the truth. People don't want to act on the truth. I will send a famine in the land. They shall run. To and fro, to the north, to the south, to the west, to the east, searching, looking for the word of truth. He said they will not find it.
That is
why there are no truth in many churches today. That is why there is no righteousness in many churches today. That is why you see what the pastors are doing today. What has happened to the church? Because God has discovered
that
people don't want the truth. People don't love the truth.
When
you tell somebody the truth, they will get angry with you. When you point to somebody and say your life is not right, you become his enemy. You must be born again. Confrontational.
Hallelujah.
There is hunger for the word of God.
If
you find it, oh my God. If you find a church that is still holding to the word of God, that is still standing on the word of God, that can still preach the word of God, point at sin in your life, that can still preach the word of God. This is the way. Walk therein. Be careful.
We told
you. You don't lose it. Jesus said,
yes,
you will know the truth.
The
truth is, people are searching for it. Hold the truth. Can I hear your amen? Oh my God. Can I hear your
amen?
Hold the truth. Hold the truth. Run for the truth. Stand for the truth. Defend the truth.
truth, live by the truth. That is church. Anything apart from this is religion.
It's
religion. Empty religion. That is why there are so many preaching. The lives of people are not changing. That is why there are so many prophets.
The
sin is multiplying. That's why there are so many
apostles.
Self-proclaimed apostles. But the church is still what we're seeing today. I pray.
That's it.
Have you been searching for the truth? Have you been looking for the truth? Have you found the truth? Have you seen the truth? If you are finding here, here I stand. I will be the last pastor to gather a crowd. And I will close my mouth from preaching the truth. Now, when I want to preach on marriage, I will choose their face.
Is
talking like that?
He's
talking to me. I will not pastor that kind of a church. Because I have a responsibility. I'm not just a preacher. I love my own life. Can I hear your
amen?
I love my own life. I am also going to heaven. If I mislead you, I'm going to mislead myself. If I mislead you, I will miss the kingdom of God. Many preachers today, listen to me. Many preachers today, they will be disappointed. They will be disappointed.
He gave us a time.
I said, I had a big crowd.
Not if you tell me,
big crowd. I had a private jet.
Not if you tell me,
I was driving in a big jeep.
Not yet,
I
have
the money. I
have
the building.
Not if you do.
I prophesy. I cast out devil. I never knew you.
It is in the
depart part for me.
Mommy,
you don't walk in my
city.
You will not be deceived.
Now,
I say you will not be deceived. Let me read something which is very serious. 2 Timothy chapter 4. Preach the word. Even if they refuse to hear, preach the word. Chapter 4, verse number 1. I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and kingdom. Come on, pastor, preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears, and they shall turn their ears from the truth, and shall be turned to fables. Watch therefore, in all things, endure affliction. Come on, evangelist, do the work of an evangelist, make a full proof of their ministry. The Bible says, preach the word. Hallelujah. Say, pastor, preach the word.
But the pastor is
point and nil.
The Bible says,
pastor, preach the word.
Pastor, this is
that is the only thing I will preach.
And
you will say, I shall preach.
When they
are ready to obey. Can I hear your amen? The Bible says, because time will come when people will not want to hear sound doctrine. And because they will not want sound doctrine, they will be searching for pastors that will tell them what they like. They will be looking for churches that will tell them the things that they want to hear.
They
say preach it. They don't want to hear. Preach it. Even if they rebel, preach it. Why? So that it shall be against them for judgment. So that nobody should say, I did not hear. And the Bible says they shall turn their ears from the truth and they shall be turned to fables. Do you know what that means? When they come to church, they forget the truth. They leave the Bible. They read one verse of the scripture. They talk all the stories. They talk stories about their life, about their achievements, about their families, about story about this. The whole church is full of stories today. But I want to tell you that if you want to go to heaven, if you want to live a good life on earth, open your ears to the truth. Can I hear you?
Amen.
Amen. You know, one of our brothers one man came to our church in America. As he came, then the pastor was preaching on marriage. He pointed out from the scripture that once married, forever married. He said marriage is monogamy. One man, one woman. That man was offended. I don't like this church. Because he wants to divorce this one, number one, and marry another one. If this other one is disturbing me, I divorce that one, I marry another one. Pastor, the way you are preaching, it shows that I cannot drive away my wife. I will look for a different church. That man left. 14 months. He went to 14 churches. Time denominations. He went to the first church and spent one full month in that church. He didn't hear the truth. He left. This is a life story. He went to the second church. One month. He didn't see it. He left. He went to another one. One month. He didn't see the truth. He left. After 14 churches. One Sunday. The pastor saw him come. If you run away from this deep land, one day you will come back.
No, who could have only deep land?
Hallelujah. Because we will come back and meet the same one we are preaching. We will not change it.
Now,
it is the medicine that is going to cure this world of sin. The day the man was coming, the pastor saw him. Welcome, stranger. Welcome, stranger. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The man said, ah, I'm not a stranger. I am back. See where you're coming from. They say, I'm back. Back to the very church. They say, Pastor, you know something? I went to 14 churches in 14 months. I didn't hear the truth.
Now, put in movies.
And I accept that marriage is one man. It is one woman. Till death do us
part. God is through by tongue.
Amen. And I hear you, amen.
Amen.
You cannot do anything with the truth. But you can only do something for the truth. If you run away from the truth, the truth will pursue you. The truth will search for you. Want to consider three things. Number one, divine promise to believers during economic crisis.
He says,
there are promises in the Bible that show us that God still loves us, divine promises to believers during economic crisis. Number two, determining factors of believers' prosperity during crisis. Determining factors of believers' prosperity during crisis. And I will talk about the last one, believers' faithfulness during economic crisis. Very fast, let's go to point number one. Divine promises to believers during economic crisis. Jesus became poor so that we can be rich.
Yes, that's
and you will be rich in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You know when we talk about riches, some people just think about my bank account. No.
Oh yeah.
If you have money in the bank, that's not riches. You must be rich spiritually. Rich materially. Rich infrastructurally. Rich in all domains. Your life affecting other people. Somebody is putting his putting food on his table because of you. I'm reading Psalm 37 verse 25. I have been young and now I am old. I have not seen the righteous forsaken, neither his seed begging bread.
Verse 37, verse 25.
I have not seen a righteous man forsaken by God, abandoned by God. I have not seen their children begging bread on the streets. Hallelujah. Your children will not beg bread. You yourself, you will not beg bread. You will not go to the street and say, help me in the name of the Lord. David said, I have not seen the righteous man. You know what the Bible says? A righteous man. That man's end shall be peace. Because the eyes of God are upon the righteous. Let me read something. 34 verse 10. The same book. Psalms 34 verse 10. I read. The young lion do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing.
Can I hear you?
Amen. Hallelujah. If that scripture is true in your life, can you raise your hand and say,
amen.
The Bible says, lack and suffer hunger. The young lions can lack and suffer hunger. But the man that seeks the Lord, the man that follows the Lord, the man that obeys the Lord, the man that lives according to the word of God, he shall not want any good thing. Whatever you pray for, whatever you desire, the Bible says the Lord will grant the desires of your heart. While others are losing their jobs, you will be getting more jobs. It is prophecy.
Or
you wanted me to shake. Paul says the Lord, I have said by the prophetic word of God that you will not lack. bread.
Yuko utaza mutima.
You will not lack any good thing.
Na chiza uzabura.
You know, I prophesied to one church.
I told the hand
in my country.
Which you watch?
The church was told. Well, I don't understand what was happening. Those who had cars. The cars broke down. And almost the whole church was checking. We had place to park, but there were no cars to park there. There were no cars.
Okay.
We had a parking space, but we didn't have cars.
Okay. No, nobody. Then
in one joint service.
I
told them.
Never begin.
You know when God speaks.
Sometimes
we don't hear. I prophesied to them. I told them.
Never begin.
That we will get your own car. Some say amen, some did not want to say
amen.
I don't even have one. I don't even have
one to sign.
But some say amen. Some say we believe.
But say,
I'm telling you. If you go to that church today, you will be shocked. It was not long. This one has bought it.
Oh, you were going to go to
the pastor, praise the Lord. I got a car.
Now, when you go to the
pastor, praise the Lord.
Pastor,
I got a car.
Now, because you
want to, I myself, I got my own.
Now, you can't get a car.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I was part of the blessing.
Thank you. Now, where you go, you'll be shocked.
Then another sister.
When you wish you
came to my office.
As a believer.
He said, Pastor.
Pastor.
This one is surprising.
Somebody
gave me.
How are you, my good
room? A brand new car.
He went to cash out.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That
says
that as you believe God,
and
you walk with God,
you
will not lack any good thing.
Now, Jesus,
the choir was singing here.
I am a millionaire.
My Father has all things.
But that's
believe it.
Jesus,
accept it.
Yeah,
it will change the condition of your family. Don't look at your pocket. Look at the pocket of the Almighty.
God.
I said, look at the pocket of the Almighty God. You know, when you have suffered too much, when you hear prophecy of prosperity,
sometimes
it's very difficult to believe. Because you have suffered until you are used to poverty. You see a rich man. The first thing that comes into your mind is that man is an occulting man.
How can
he have money like
this?
That money is not natural. It's society. Because you have customized yourself. You have caged yourself. What you can try, you can achieve. Let me give you another precious promise. Exodus chapter 23. And I also turn the Bible to the other side and tell you something. So that you don't behave like other people.
Like other pastors.
So don't tell you will prosper. They don't show you how you are going to prosper. Chapter 23, I'm reading verse 25. And he shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy water, and he shall take sicknesses away from the midst of thee. Then shall nothing cast thy yoke, nor be barren in thy land. The number of thy days I, the Lord, will fulfill. You will not die young. You don't be shaking like a leaf in the forest.
Now,
pandemic has come now. Maybe I will die. Forget about it.
Where are you going?
I said what?
Forget.
The pandemic has been here. For how long now? For a whole year. When it started here, I told you that none of you will be infected. As you bow your head and enter this church, a seal of God is on your face. Those who believe it will receive it. I want to read you Isaiah chapter 33, verse 16. He shall dwell in the high. His place of defense shall be the munitions of the rock. Look at this. Bread shall be given him. His waters shall be sure.
Amen. Aza haba ibyo kurya bimutunga n'amazi yo kunywa naza yabura.
You need bread, bread
y'umutima umutima uzawuhabwa.
You will not lack food in your family in Jesus' name.
Naho uzabona ibyo kurya mu muryango wa Israel.
Psalms 1.
Zaburi ya mbere.
I'm reading from verse 1. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. His delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaves shall not wither. Whatsoever he doeth shall prosper.
Hahirwa umuntu udakurikiza imigambi y'ababi, n'ahagaremuza y'abanyabyaha, n'iyishyari n'abakubanyi, ahubwo amategeko y'Uwiteka niyo yishimira, kandi amategeko ye niyo yibwira ku manywa na nijoro. Wazabona n'igiti cyatewe hafi y'umugezi cyeri muto zacyo, igihe cyacyo, ibibabi byacyo n'ibyuma, icyo azakora cyose kizamubera cyiza.
Jeremiah chapter number 17.
Yeah, chapter 17.
Hear what the Bible says. These are precious promises.
I am a teacher.
For he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of waters, that spreadeth out its root, her root by the river, and shall not see. Listen very well. And shall not see when the heat cometh. But her leaves shall be green, and shall not be careful in the year of drought, in the year of hunger, neither shall they cease yielding fruit. Jeremiah 17:8.
Uwo kuko azakwana n'igiti cyatewe hafi y'amazi gishorera imizi mu migezi, n'ikizatinya amapfa nacana, ahubwo ikibabi cyacyo kizahora itoto, n'ikizita ku mwaka wacanwemo amapfa, kandi n'ikizareka kwera imbuto zacyo.
Hallelujah. I say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, there are some things that the Bible says.
Hari ibintu bimwe bivuga.
That you need to look at your life and see whether those things are fulfilling in your life.
He said
his own children, his children,
children
of God, they are like trees that are planted by the rivers of water. And the roots go into that river.
They
said they don't know when there is rainy season. They don't know when there is dry season. They will always be fruitful. Now, look at yourself. Can you say that your life has been fruitful? That's what, sir.
You are
a child of God. There are times, completely unbelievers are crying and weeping. You yourself, you are crying and weeping with them. They don't have food, you don't have food. They are sick, they don't have money to go to the hospital. You yourself, you don't even have. Your own children are at home. Praise God.
Man,
you know, I want to praise God for Rwandans. It is something to praise God. Because to educate a child in Rwanda is very expensive. Am I right?
Yes.
Am I right? Yes.
No.
Even the schools that are very cheap. To me, they are still expensive. You know, in Cameroon,
what is in Cameroon?
Every government school, primaries,
there
is no school fees. It is free.
No room.
The highest fee you can pay for the whole year is
2,500.
For the whole year. That one is given to parent association. Government takes nothing from you. Now go to secondary. For the whole year. Pay 15,000. 15,000 is like 20,000
Rwandan
francs. For the whole year. Then I see people here.
See
educating children.
You
should be going to school. You are children. We have enough. I say your children will have enough. Good school. Now, I want to now ask myself, why is it that all these promises are in the Bible and believers are not prospering? That's the question all of us must ask. That's the question you must ask yourself. Why is it that the promises are there and people are not prospering? You know, a brother got up one day and told the wife, because he had some messages from another church, that the pastor was, someone was testifying, that he prayed fervently that God should give him money. When he got up in the morning and opened his pillow, he saw money inside.
Send that money.
You know that people lie today on the pulpit.
What is covered with that?
Those are lies. They want to make people happy. They want to feel that they are spiritual giant, they can pray.
Lies.
Without any apology. Many testimonies that people shout in places and give those testimonies are fake. Then this brother, hearing that one,
being
in the deeper level,
under
my ministry,
he
told the wife, these deeper level, maybe they are not praying well.
They are
teaching like this.
If you got to preach,
that church is better.
They are told,
they say, I'm going to go to the mountain. My wife,
madam,
don't tell the pastor.
No, the pastor.
And you pray.
That's it.
If God does not send me money,
on
that mountain, I will die there.
That
they say, after 3 days,
my wife,
if you don't see me,
madam,
you can tell the pastor, they can come and collect my cost.
Pastor,
you Time of manna has passed. And you see that you are praying and praying and say, oh God, when I get up tomorrow, I should see money. Even if you come and sleep in this church, you will sleep here and get up and go to the house and look for food. Thank God. The sister of the wife.
Came and saw the note.
Immediately.
He
said, Pastor must hear this.
They
called me, Pastor, where
are you? Pastor
said, I'm here. Meet me.
Where to go
now? Something important to tell
you.
The sister of the wife came.
They said, Pastor,
do you know what my sister's husband did?
He said,
it's on the mountain, pray that God will send money from heaven.
Hallelujah.
You know, some of us are radical. Some of us are radicals. Radical preachers.
I say,
sister, don't fall in the car. Let's drive there. We are going to climb on that mountain. I will bring him down. He is not ready to die yet. Before he dies there, I will carry him from there and bring him down. We drove to that village.
Hallelujah.
Church is not, we are not playing church here.
Now
we are preaching the word of God. Believe the word. Stand by the word. You will prosper. He was there for the first day. For the second day. Hunger, discipline. He became too hungry. He ran away from there.
And
came down to the village.
When
we reached the village, we saw the man fetching firewood. Hallelujah. Into the car. I said, my brother,
the money that
have you gotten the money?
You say, my friend,
no cover. They say, Pastor.
At Pastor.
I left that thing.
At what? You don't have it.
The food he was supposed to be looking for, he went to go and pray. That's what I'm talking about. Determining factors for believers' prosperity.
There
are things that you must do if you want to prosper. If you don't do it, forget it. If a prophet is telling you, then come, I will just prophesy on you, and money will just fall down. If I see that money, I will not pick it, it's
occultic.
If you tell me, just pray. When you get up in the morning, you will see bags of rice standing here. If I see the rice, I will not eat. It is occultic. Let me read from I want to read you something in Psalms 1. So that as children of God, believers, we should not think that being holy makes you just prosperous.
No, man, so that
you come another Sunday and say, Pastor, you say we will prosper. I have not prospered. Disclaimer. A disclaimer. I am not a little doctor. That will come and just spray money. Oh yeah. Already from the Bible.
Never seen a video.
Look at what the Bible says. In Psalms 1:3.
Zaburi
Psalms chapter 1, verse 3. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaves also shall not wither. Look at what the Bible says. Whatsoever he doeth shall prosper.
Zaburi ya mbere, mungu wakatatu, wazawara ni giti chate hafi mujezi, chera imbuto zacho, ije chacho, ibabyacho ni byuma, icho azakora cyose kizamubera cyiza.
That is the bottom line of everything. Because some people just read part A. The Bible says I will be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. And they're singing all about. Pastor preaching the church today. All of us. We are like trees planted by the rivers of water. We shall only be bringing fruit. Prospering. Hold on. Whatsoever he doeth,
choose.
If you are not doing anything, forget about prosperity. Forget it. Amen.
Amen.
If there is any prayer you pray for prosperity, listen to me.
You
are praying that God, show me what I can do. So that you can use that thing and prosper me. If you come and sit here in the church here, maybe the whole night,
where is your choice?
Lord, prosper me.
I will not
disturb you. You have all the time. I don't have all that time. Because after you must have wasted all that energy, you will rise up and have nothing. But if you were to pray, you are going to pray that God, you have given me a head to think. You have given me hands. You have given me legs. You have given me strength. Show me what I can do. To discover extra harsh riches. To point something to me, I will do it. No matter how dirty the job
will be.
That is the prayer God will answer. That is the prayer God will answer. If you pray another one, you will come back and see me and talk the same story. I want to make you understand that. James chapter 2. Those who say we have faith, we have faith. God will provide, God will provide. James chapter 2. So that you understand that the Bible is balanced. The balance is, the Bible is not what people are deceiving us to be. That they just tell you, you will go to America. You will have visa. And when people are saying amen, you say amen. If you say that, I will not say amen because I'm not getting visa, I'm not going to America.
Chapter 2, verse 18.
Even verse 18 says, yea, a man may say, thou hast faith, and I have works. Show me thy faith without thy works, and I will show thee my faith by my works.
Yazavuga ati wewe ufite kwizera jewe ufite imirimo nyereka kwizera kwawe utagira imirimo nanjye ndakwereka kwizera kwanjye kugaragazwa n'imirimo yanjye.
Look at verse 20. But when thou know, O vain man, useless man, a man without reasoning, that faith without works is dead.
Verse
26. For as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is also dead. Faith does not make anybody rich.
Hallelujah. Amen.
That might wonder this. Faith does not make anybody rich. If faith was not to make people rich, I'm telling you, all of us will begin just to be developing the faith.
They can get quest.
We will just develop strong faith. We will carry all of you like this. We will lock ourselves inside this hall. Since from that day, I have never tested anything in my mouth that is fried.
That was
my gift.
Gas. And I went into the house, I gave her.
I
said, brother.
Come
and teach my wife this. That was the answer to the prayer she prayed.
And you know what she said?
You know
how we
get the name of Italy?
Is that what it is?
I need more.
Ngo nyongera.
That is how we get the name.
Nijos
get
what?
Not mandas.
I mandas.
I need more.
Nye, nyongera.
There was no way.
Now, yo.
She started frying it.
Yata nyewete.
She carries on her head.
Katira kumutwe.
Regional pastor's wife.
Madame wa pastor lesonani.
She's carrying deep, a bucket on her head.
Iko indo ya mandas
mutwe. Moving on the streets.
Agenda muhanda kulisha.
When I talk about regional pastor, I'm not talking about national overseer of Rwanda.
Iyo mvuze pastor national wa chinagori yunguyu representative gari mu Rwanda.
We are talking about regional pastor.
Iyo mvuze pastor national abantu mukomeye cyane.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's controlling thousands.
Abayo yabani bihumbi n'ibihumbi.
Then my wife.
Ari madam
was carrying bucket.
Ya tebido
on her head. Kumutwe on the street.
Kumuhana.
If you buy one,
ura mutsukuze rimwe gusa.
As she goes,
akagenda.
You will come and please, madam.
Ne ukanga inyuma nyamuna mama ngaruka.
Come back.
Garuka.
Some people may be coming every day. You are passing. Drop me here.
Bring my own here. Baba kama kumanda ba tuli musu mje yecho sianga juzani.
Let me tell you how it prospers.
Ne kama kiri ukumbiya kumbas.
God prosper that business.
Business.
The fact that the whole family has to join us to be able to supply.
Kujaza kuwego umudiango sekifata jisemo kujamuwa na wajamu tutange imanja zaidi.
The whole family.
Umudiango
we must work because.
Tangu na ukora.
You have command here 10,000.
Haya madam baba I command ili umbichuli. Hali yeye umbidini. Madam.
You have to supply that command and also find the one you are going to sell.
Iyo command ukaita akandi ugate kana yani uzata majiza.
Our story changed around.
Ibuya tsubiza kuhinduka.
I can see everything turning around.
Biliyanduka divakiza.
Amen. Your situation will turn around.
Imibereho yawe iraza kuhinduka.
Only
gusa.
Today, and remove that spirit of laziness. And say, go. I have to do something with my life. You cannot be in Kabuga.
Now,
that we leave from here and go to Kabuga to go and buy things to come and sell in Kigali. And you have no food to eat. And you are doing nothing. You are sitting by the door of the market. Ask yourself, those women that are selling in the market, do they have horns?
Yes,
horns on their head. Those people that are succeeding, what do they have that you don't have? You have more than what they have. Because you have Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They don't have Jesus. They spend money on women. What does a man spend his money for? That's what we spend our money for. We go to the bar, we drink.
You are not drinking
alcohol.
No chimizoga.
You are not sharing money to women.
No,
you are not wasting money.
No,
you don't have.
God
with God.
Now
go and look for something.
Hallelujah.
Hey, I
say hallelujah.
Well, if you say, I say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is what will
bring
you a miracle.
Hallelujah.
When you start the business. When you start the thing. You know. God will use that thing.
Imani za kolesho chinu
and will be a blessing to you.
Chiku Yesu kutisha.
Let me read you something.
Kama somera ha.
In Deuteronomy.
Utika kwa kabi.
Deuteronomy.
Utika kwa kabi.
Let me give you this tip today.
Deka mbahe ibi.
Kujya kumenya
karakteri ukwezwa kwezwa gusa bizagukungahaza.
You can be holy and poor at the same time.
Oshobora kuba wese kandi ukanakira.
Muri
Bibiliya birimo.
But if you want to be holy and rich at the same time, it is okay.
Ariko niba ushaka kwezwa ukaba n'umukire birashoboka kandi byiza.
You want to become Lazarus, it is okay for you.
Ariko niba ushaka kwibera Lazaro nabyo nta kibazo.
But I want to become Abraham.
Ariko njye ndashaka kuba Abraham.
I want to become Job. You know Job?
Job
was the richest in the East.
Job, yari umukire utabandi basazuba.
He will prosper.
Now uzakungahara.
Chapter
28.
I want to pick verse 3.
Umunwa gatatu.
Uteka chapter 28 verse 3.
Uteka 28 gatatu.
Blessed shall that be in the city. And blessed shall that be in the field. They marking something. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body and the fruit of thy ground. The fruit of thy cattle, the increase of its kind, and the flock of thy sheep. Blessed shall be thy basket and thy storehouse. Oh my God, watching something. Blessed shall be that when that goeth, when that comes in, and blessed shall be when thy goest out.
Uzagira umugisha mu mudugudu uzawugira no mu murima. Hazagira umugisha imbuto zo mu nda yawe n'imyaka yo ku butaka bwawe. N'imbuto z'amatungo yawe. Korora ku inka zawe no ku mikumbi yawe. Hazagira umugisha igitenga cyawe n'ikimbo uvugiramo. Uzagira umugisha mu majya no mu maza. Uwiteka za. Amen.
You know what the Bible is saying here? Blessed shall be the fruit of thy ground. Some people just read the Bible without even marking what is there.
You
are where there is a farm. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy ground. And you are walking nothing. The ground is there.
You are walking nothing.
Let me shock you. When we came to Rwanda, almost the first year,
we
were buying vegetables. Every vegetable went to the market.
So,
let me tell you, for 4 years, we have not gone to the market to buy vegetables.
Say it
bigger.
Say it
bigger.
Gusa ari iwanjye mu mbuga.
To buy vegetables.
Now to show question about
you walk in dry season, rainy season.
Urazi turarya imboga haba kumeshi haba mu gihe cy'imvura imboga zihazi.
We are eating vegetable here more than we eat in Cameroon.
Turarya imboga no kuta nubwo twazitega turi muri Cameroon.
You are sitting in your compound.
Where we say, I'm going.
A big space is there.
Nothing.
You know, some people are very funny. What are you thinking? Can you not, even if you don't have ground anywhere?
You are using
rice and throwing bags. Bags and bags are littered everywhere. Why don't put ground inside those bags and stand them, and they become your own farm?
Kuki dapata abantu bajibiche bakazugunya iyo mifuka bayizugunya wakati mifuka pachira bitaka ukateramo inyo ukeneye niba zimboga ukayitondekanya gutya uwo ni umurima wawe.
If you are living in a compound and you have a space,
niba ari ahantu
even too small,
akaba ari ahantu ubwo akaba kari gatoya.
Buy vegetables. And go and buy spices.
And
go and buy spices. In the market. I will say you are not a woman. You are not a woman. If you are a woman, you will think. You will think.
What it is?
God will help us.
Man is at the first.
I said the Lord
will help us. That man is at
the first. The increase of their sheep and their cattle.
God of a queen as I will need now, man be kumi.
Do you know that there are people that don't even have a fowl?
What is God about? But the fit, but the things that need me, any, but they imoko suri.
Imoko. They don't have a fowl.
Now, imoko
if you have a fowl.
Imoko.
They don't have.
Now, muskim.
They are human beings.
Never, never, never.
If they want to, do you know how expensive to buy a fowl here is?
Ozo kunanga bihesa kuri imoko.
inyama y'inkoko
ariko
ukaba utuye ahantu
utuye
mu
nzu
ntarimo ufite
You live in the village. You don't have a goat.
Uri mu cyaro ngiyo no udafite ihene.
Nothing.
Naki.
You when you remove that your kitchen remains.
Urazi iyo maze guteka ugasanga ibyo bisigazwa ibyo kujya wenda ibyo mu gikoni.
You are calling for sanitation.
Ugahamagara abantu b'abanyesu ngo batware imyanda.
Come and help me carry it to go and through.
Muze mufashe gutwara imyanda mujye kujugunya.
You could have been feeding a father.
Yakagira gabo rimoko.
Lord, deliver us.
Man is at the cheese.
Let me show you something.
Can you show me?
Ecclesiastes chapter 9.
Mugirizi che.
Ecclesiastes chapter 9.
Mugirizi.
Let me show you
something. Mugabe yawe, icho mwereka.
Even those who say they are working.
Now, what about after kazi?
The question is, how much are you earning?
Nakubazi chivazu. There's no way. Nanga.
Nobody can be rich. Depending on salary.
No musharo.
It is not possible.
Ni shogo.
It is not.
Now no shogo.
Let me show you this.
Tekabiriki.
Those who are earning can testify.
Abuga ndi kuvuga ho bashaka kutangu hamya.
You want to tell them they can testify.
Bo ga bashaka kutangu hamya.
Look at the
stand.
Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with all thy might. For there is no work, no device, no knowledge, no wisdom in the grave whither that goes.
Omulimo wawe wose werekeje amaboko yawe ukorane umwete kuko ikuzimu aho uzajya nanimwo nta migambi uzahabona haba no kumenya cyangwa ubwenge.
Well, let me surprise you here.
They can come.
God has given us wisdom.
Imana yaduhaye ubwenge.
That wisdom and knowledge is to use it here.
Ubwo bwenge n'ubumenyi bwo kubukoresha hano.
It's not to go and use it in heaven.
Ntabwo kujya kuzakoresha mu
ijuru. We don't need wisdom in heaven.
Mwejuru ntabwo tuzajya
dukeneye.
Ntabwo tuzajya mu ijuru.
Useless.
Ntacyo tuzarimo.
But God has given us that knowledge.
Ariko Imana yaduhaye
ubumenyi. So that we can use it on this planet earth and succeed here.
Ibyo tumenye tubikoreshe kuri uyu mugabane wo ku isi kugira ngo tugire icyo tugeraho.
Let me tell you.
Kamba bwije.
If you call a poor man,
uramucamaga umukene
and give him money,
ukamuha amafaranga.
He will take your money,
azafata amafaranga
and eat it on his poverty.
Ayarye ayarya mu bukene
and remain poor.
Akomeze kuba ari umukene.
Give him 100,000.
Muhe ibihumbi ijana.
He will come the next year as 50.
Ubutaza ndoka agusaye 50,000.
I don't have capital.
Nagishoro mfite.
That is a lie.
Kindi kinyoma.
Capital is here.
Igishoro ni hano.
This is capital. This big thing I'm carrying is capital.
If you have
this hair, that is your capital. It's not anywhere. This head can bring money. This head can think. This head can divide. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Use your head. Touch this your head. I will use my head. You are not using it.
Now, why you are using
it? You are using it. You will not be here.
You have been far now.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is Lord.
Yes.
Oh my God, I say He is Lord.
That's a good man.
Let me show you the problem that believers have.
Kambere kichipaza vizi na bapi.
Romans chapter number 12 verse 11. Abraham
chumba kambi chumba nini?
Romans chapter 12 verse 11.
Abraham chumba kambi nini? Romans chumba nini?
Show you what is the problem of believers.
Nakwele kichipaza vizi na bapi.
Verse 11. Not slothful in business, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord.
Kupjomete imume inyangwe muhimbane umitima ukorere umwami wacu.
Can you understand that verse? They say not slothful in business. That people today you give them job. It is very difficult. difficult.
What
is difficult there? You show them something to do. The money is small. You know, I have seen something in Rwanda that shocks me. Sincerely yours. To be sincere. If you live like this in my country, you will die. Somebody brought a vehicle with plants. And some boys came to remove the plants.
Because
to remove the plants and put them. Give us 15,000. If you don't give us,
you will
not.
Now it's soft.
The man pleaded.
He
said, no.
Oh, yeah.
They prefer to go and sit doing nothing than collect the 5,000 in less than 25 minutes. I stood by to watch what that man was
doing.
As a leper, you were shouting. I laughed.
That's it.
I say you have not seen problem. That man carefully removed his phone that he was wearing. Remove his phones. Remove his things.
I should
and climb up.
I take you
to the removing the plant.
Hey, when
they saw that the man is removing it is not that there is no work. Many of us are not willing to work. Many are not willing. How can somebody be in this place? A whole man who has nothing to do. Main bicycle.
He
cannot ride bicycle. Main bicycle. About my pastor here. Who is riding bicycle? He is a builder.
No, Mubati.
Number two, he is riding bicycle. If there is no building work, he is on the road riding bicycle.
Amen.
You are waiting for me to give you charity. Somebody said, if you want your church to be poor, begin to share money to members. You will have the poorest church on earth. Now, but what if I give you charity? What do you do with the charity? If I give you 10,000, what do you do with
it? Why do you do with it?
Ah, God bless you, sir. That is what they will eat that day. They are going to buy meat. They are going to buy chicken. They are going to buy this. They will cook a big pot of soup that day.
I take for I take air and supply use sauce.
People have suffered. You want to be poor.
You are
a poor man. If somebody gives you that charity,
5,000, 10,000,
put it down.
Yes,
what can I do with this? I can do something. I can get to the market.
So
I can get up early in the market.
I
am bringing those things from the vehicle. Pastor will give us a
pastor that will hand in us.
If he doesn't, he's not a good man.
I'm
a good man.
Hallelujah.
I must tell you the truth. That is the hand is the only way.
Is that God that knows that?
There is something you must mark.
How did you come up with it?
There's something you must mark.
How did you come up with it?
Let me show you in the New Testament. If I say you will succeed, I have a prophetic declaration. How will the words of the pastor come to pass? Now God will show you this is what you are supposed to
do. This
is what you are supposed to do. You know, I came here. I told a brother. I said, go and learn
shoemending.
He didn't.
He
did not. Then just some one thing last month, when I spoke last month or so. I was moving around.
And
I went and met a shoemaker. I told the brother with whom I was working.
No, we are going to
I said, bro,
you went that.
I am interested in this man.
Even
though the man was not understanding me. Then I brought one of my shoes.
Nzana, rumeto zanje.
I said, Pastor, don't worry, I will make you the shoe.
I'm like Pastor, humura rumeto ne ukudote.
That is the shoe I'm wearing today.
Is it rumeto namba you move si nizoni kwa bi anuwa zitos?
If you go to the if I remove the shoe and show you.
Ndamutse urukoto nkuye mchele ngano kwega.
That somebody made that shoe.
Na wa gizi la kwa bumu zitos.
In his workshop.
Mwa tu diye.
Then I ask myself.
I
say people are roaming up and down. How long can it take somebody to learn? I'm made in Nigeria.
Now in Nigeria.
Who is making big money?
He's
a repairer.
Now we
fridges or any electronic man can repair.
No one repairer, frigo, just electronic.
I brought my fridge for him to repair.
Now we have a frigo that we have to buy.
This head is to fish.
We you must go to teach.
I'm asking.
Now we
say please.
Now
when I look, no, I know.
We were in the hand.
Say pastor.
At pastor,
I am surprised.
There are numbers.
You see this boy.
Well, the Muslim.
He is working with me.
We move to Akura.
He prefers that I should pay him.
I tell you, wait. I say when you go to Jamuishwa.
Than to learn this work.
How could you go give you work?
He told me, Pastor.
I
want to train for free.
Njenda shabuwa na shabuji shabu.
Someone that can be working with me.
Omunu akwana
nje. Pastor, do you know that I don't have any single person?
Arabu said, Pastor, when you see kona mungu na ina boda.
That is ready.
We take you
to train. They don't have jobs. They don't want to work. Do you know?
What do you see?
That in one that
you go
a student will take his shit to the dry cleaner. Take his trousers and to the dry cleaner. Will pay rather than washing it himself. Then the brother with whom I was.
No, my daughter went to the
room. Look at that brother on the face. Can you not learn this work?
Listen, I will be your cousin.
He said, Pastor, this is good.
At Pastor, in the case,
it ended there.
Be so deserved.
It died a natural death.
Be pitiful.
What do you want Pastor to do?
We shall not pass the court of the chief.
Should I cut my head?
He said,
I'm giving you.
You should not
cut my head. This is church.
I
refuse to pastor poor churches.
Even the one that's
Even the one
Never say they are telos. Can you open the
workshop?
And people will not beat you in that workshop. Customers will not beat you there. You're not an expert. Somebody cannot be here in the church. And you are brethren.
No, no, when you
carry their clothes and look for somebody else. You don't trust your soul. May God change us and change us totally in Jesus. We can all succeed together. But let me point out some things here. When there are crises, if you want to save, if you want to stay afloat, number one, stressing how you spend your money. Because some people say, I don't have money.
But
they don't think they spend every day. If they see mandas,
they
will buy, put in their mouth.
They
enter into a shop.
They
see bonbon. Sweet. With a very long stick.
You see an adult.
What is in your mouth? Are we thinking at all? Number two.
Chakarit.
Cut that cost.
Gaganya, if you could have a frank.
If you are eating meat, eat vegetable.
Never jaginya matimboga.
I look at something this morning.
I look at meat.
I look at soya beans.
Never that soya.
Now I wanted to see something.
Now has a dichin.
100 grams of soya beans.
Amagadama is a soya.
How much protein does it contain? And 100 grams of meat.
No, they say nyadina is a namagadama is a na yinyama.
You discover,
I discovered
that 100 grams of soya beans.
Navigo Amagadama is a naya soya.
Contains 42.9% of protein. But 100 grams of meat contains only 26% of protein.
Animo, the soya has?
Soya beans has 42.9.
Soya, if it takes you know,
But meat contains 26.
Mujiani, Yamahadi, Mokumiani, Nagatana to Sabuja.
You have to eat meat.
But
be careful the way you eat. What is the philosophy I'm bringing here? When things are difficult, cut down costs. When When you want to send money, cut down cost.
There are some things that
at some time you must remove them from your pot. You must remove them from your kitchen. Because you want to do something. Women, listen to me. If you want your husband to remain a poor man, open the door of your kitchen. Open it big. All the income of the family will enter into that kitchen. Fry the income.
Cook
the income. Finish everything. You can feed your family with the minimum you have. If you look, I don't eat meat. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Am I fine? Am I sick? I'm a vegetarian. Strong and healthy. But I see people who don't have anything. It's not because I want to economize. I just want to be a vegetarian. Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the Lord help us.
That's his mind. First,
go from today.
Live your
life. And let God bless you. Lastly, let me just tell you something. Now, what you need to do is strategies to avoid waste. In this pandemic.
In this pandemic,
know your income. Know your income. How much are you earning? Number two. Beware of unplanned expenses.
Beware.
When you are going to the market, as a woman, have a list.
This is
what I'm going to buy in the market. When you enter the market, buy only what you went to the market to buy. Don't buy any other additional thing that is not in your list. Rwanda is not like Cameroon. It is like Cameroon.
Cameroon.
Your pastor says, hey, 100, 200, they throw clothes here. You will branch it. This one is very cheap. You buy. Before you come back from the market, you will bring loot from the market that was not inside your list.
Yo, uchie kumuhanda, nisoko, wala kwa 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 kwa
kwa kwa crisis. Cut down expenses to the basics.
Gabanya, ubujisora mafranga kugira ku rwego rw'ubushobozi
bwawe. You can manage the dresses you have now. You can manage.
Ushobora kwakoreshwa rwego ya kunyenda ufite.
You will buy clothes but not now.
Yenyenda kintu zayo ariko si ubu.
You will buy shoes but not now.
Yenyenda kintu zayo ariko si ubu.
You can manage them for now.
Ushobora gukoresha ifite ubu.
What again?
Number
four. Before you buy anything, there are three questions you will ask.
Number
one. Did I budget for this? Did I plan to buy this thing? If the answer is no, walk away. No matter how good that thing is. Number two question. Is it necessary? If I don't buy, what will happen? Can I do without this? If the answer is yes. If the answer is no. This thing is not necessary. You have another one now.
Oh, what about you?
Number three. Can I do without it? If I don't buy, what will happen? My sister, walk away.
And
the things we have to do. As we go to pray, well, I will read to maybe two scriptures. Believers' faithfulness during economic crisis. I want to read to you two scriptures. Because at times, when there are challenges, people tend to become funny. People tend to become unfaithful. And think that it is unfaithfulness that will make them to succeed. If you become unfaithful, you will not succeed. If you become dubious, you will not succeed. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. I'm taking this time to open your eyes to these things. So that you don't go and come back and say, Pastor, you say I was going to succeed. I did not succeed. I will send you back to the Word of God. This is what I showed you. Look at verse 2.
They have
renounced hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness. And then. Be faithful. Be honest. The world is looking for honest people. Whatever thing you are doing, be honest. Are you selling in the market? Be honest. Let me tell you something about honesty. Honesty is a big capital. You are honest. You don't have money. Someone will help you to succeed.
Amen.
I'm telling you the truth. Somebody can prefer to give you goods to go and sell.
Pay
him because he trusts you. But if you are not honest, there are people, even if you employ them today, if they enter your business today,
they
will start to disappear from that business. They will start to steal. They will start to pick things. Their hands will spoil. They will become dirty. Because they want to steal, pick something and go. Are you honest? You speak the truth. Are you truthful? You cannot play. I sat in a shop that was supplying the government.
There
was money at our disposal like this. You want to steal as what? That man trusted us. He never made any check. He never cross checked. He does not pay your salary. You have your book. When the month ends, you remove the salary from the business with your own hand.
Pay your salary.
And write it in the book. If they give that opportunity to some of us here, how are you going to be? Money will disappear to the village. Another secret account. Unfaithfully. That's how we live our life. Somebody will come and say, supply me goods for 1 million. When you write the invoice, the person will come to the counter. Say, please. It is this
good.
Just give me 200,000 francs cash. Consider this good supply.
No, no, of the people,
take the money and go.
I
will say, man, these are your goods. You will collect them. You are going to collect your
goods.
The person will go out. Children are this. People are this. They don't love money.
Now we put up a franga.
They would not know.
I don't know what
to go to our patron.
But our boss, our boss,
and tell him that those two boss in your place.
But
if you remove them, that business will crumble.
We don't go back to your business. You have to take your hands.
Hallelujah. Then we were building an integrity.
God, what go back to your anger for you?
Someone will buy something.
Baba, I can't believe you didn't pay
for 5,000.
Give me that.
I say it is my company.
But in the company,
instead of writing 5,000, write 20.
And the company,
I'll give you 5,000. If there are some of us here,
we
will write it down.
Why the one?
Forging receipt.
The seat will out.
Honesty. Honesty. Integrity.
We
pay you
one day. We must.
Malachi chapter
3.
No matter whatever prosperity you have,
it
will disobey the word of God.
It will
disappear one day like smoke. Chapter 3. Verse
8.
Will a man rob God? Ye have robbed me. Then he said, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offering. Ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithe into my storehouse, that there may be meat in my house, and prove me not therewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing, that there be no room enough to receive it. This is a scripture that if you violate it, some readers of the New Testament, they have concluded that tithe is not necessary in the New Testament. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I didn't hear it only from church.
I am
taking my time to read and to study
it.
The word of God cannot be changed. This is not to that, not to teach about tithes. I will tell you that tithe is not law.
Tithe
was right from the beginning. I will point you from the beginning right to the days of Jesus. The Bible says, you rob God by taking what belongs to Him. Let me give you one testimony and pray. A brother was crossing to Nigeria. He was crossing to Nigeria.
When
he had money inside his bag. Not small money. Inside his traveling bag. Then they call at the customs.
No, why is it?
They say you are not supposed to enter with any currency.
But I'm not saying
I'm a friend. Don't seize that money from me.
Never you gonna, but I would call.
The brother did not know.
Woman that's not sure.
And money was inside.
I'm a friend with me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says you will rebuke the devourer for yourself.
If you have man is a man in jail.
So as they say, bring your back.
But it's a back in one.
But
I never
saw you.
But
I was cheap.
When that time we do wish it,
pray one prayer.
Are you going to say this?
Say, Lord,
you have got man.
Blind the eyes.
Who mama soya?
Blind the eyes.
Who mama soya?
They search the back.
Bash shaka shaka mi
back. The back.
Bash
shake the back.
Bash
open the back.
Bash open the back.
Let me tell you, they were not able to see that money that was there.
They can't believe it. I will frown. That away that she did not wash it. What happened?
After they finish searching,
bash bara nje musaka.
Take your back.
But fight back then.
When he took his bag,
after she bought,
you know, he will be thinking maybe the money was not there.
Was yeah, yes, I'm thinking that when I'm a friend, I'm not you.
He went a little and opened the bag.
I gave me that to have from the bag.
The money still there.
I'm a friend, I'm not.
Amen.
You want to do business.
Urashaka business.
Forget about God.
Ukibagirwa Imana.
You are going with that God.
Ukagenda na Mana ufite.
You will invest that capital.
Uzashora muri business.
Something can happen just small like this.
Hari akantu gato gashobora kuba gutya.
The whole of that capital is gone.
Igishoro cyawe cyose
gitegeje. Kigende.
Kigende.
Why don't you go just 10%?
Kuki manta y'icumi kwijana gusa?
And let him preserve the rest for you.
Ikarinda ibisigaye.
You have free conscience.
Ufite ukagira
umutima nama. Utakurega
ikibi.
If I'm giving my tithe to God,
nje ndamutse nta cyacu
na kimana. It's my own.
Asiye abara
yandi. Nobody can take it.
Na waya fata.
They will touch it, I will tell him.
Muyakora ho zayibira.
Na give, get your own.
Nirakwa ya yawe man.
Belongs to me.
Na aya yo na yandi. Ya.
Those who have been faithful can testify.
Awo akomeje kuba bize barashaka kubihamya.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want to say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There will be an hunger in the last days.
Mesia kaza
The hunger for bread.
Nzayi mutima.
The hunger for the word of God. Nzayi
mutima.
You have come.
Watch.
You have discovered the word.
Wabunisha.
Won't you stand on the word?
Ese siwashi
kuno. Won't you hold on to the word?
Siwako mutisha.
This is the wisdom.
Wunigogeji.
To succeed.
But
as you leave from church today, go to your house. Ask God. Show me what to do. You are a woman. You have been eating from your husband's pocket. You are contributing nothing. Go today. Ask the Lord. What can I do?
Man,
don't think that I've spent this long message for nothing. Because it will take you time before you hear this again. You have heard it. Let it enter your head. And pray.
Say
that you will not behave like others. Oh Lord.
Man.
I have discovered the truth. I was looking for the truth. I have found the truth. Help me, Lord, to continue. The truth. Help me, Lord, to live by the truth. Help me, Lord, to go with the truth. To defend the truth. Pray unto God. Talk to God. Ask Jesus. God help me. Are you a student?
Yes.
You are going to school.
You
go and sleep. A simple example cannot pass. You keep repeating courses. You come back from school, you know nothing. Open your mouth and pray. Spend your time usefully. Spend your time judiciously. Pray to God. If you don't know what to do, God will tell you what to do. God, open my eyes. Show me what I can do
for you.
Open your mouth and pray. Open my mouth and pray. As you go today, you
will
say, oh God, help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. I have been depending on people. Depending on people. How long? Then you say, I will support my husband. I will support my husband. I will help my family. I will support my family. My children cannot be like this. Pray. God has given you head. The head to think. The wisdom. The knowledge. It is not useful in the grave. It is useful here. Use it.
Pray
to God. Let your condition change. Let your situation change. We are not building a church of beggars.
We
are building a church of human beings. Who have 10 heads to think. Who can plan for their families. Who can work for the progress of their families. Pray to God. When God blesses you, you bless the church. When God blesses you, you bless the people of God. When God blesses you, my sister, pray that the Lord will help you. You have suffered too much. It is enough. Tell yourself it is enough. Enough of this careless, useless life. You eat and eat and eat and eat. You are eating your future. Eating the future of your children. Pray to God. Pray to God. Are you becoming unfaithful?
A church,
you cannot have offering. Pray pray that God will help you.
Say, man, sir, first.
Who are you helping in the church?
Say,
who are you supporting in the church?
Say, man,
are you only in the church to depend on charity? For how long can charity help you? If somebody gives you charity today,
they
will not continue to give you charity. Pray God will help you. Pray God will help me. Pray our church
and
make us who we're supposed to be. We'll be rich spiritually. We'll rich in faith. Also rich in substance. So that you don't run into churches that they begin to prophesy that you have money. As if money will fall from heaven. It does not fall from heaven. We walk. God blesses us. Oh Lord, open my eyes. Open my eyes. Open my eyes. Those who are already walking,
can you
add another thing to that walk?
Can you add
another source of income? Can you add value to that work? In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless us all.
I'm going
to pray. But I believe that I'm going to pray a prayer that is according to God's will. Number one, you will repent if you are lazy. You will repent if you were careless. And you will promise the Lord that if you help me,
that
you open my eyes, anything you show me to do, I will obediently do it. Then my prayer will work. To talk to God, the God of the Bible.
You are a prosper.
We are balancing the scripture.
These
are your children. Lord, I pray. For those who are not born again, it is not possible for you to bless them. You will forgive their sins. You will have mercy upon their soul. You will give them salvation. You will save them. Get their names into the book of life. I pray, Lord Jesus, for those, Father Divine, O God, who have been all this time lazy, and they will not accept that they are lazy. They will blame their poverty on people. They will blame their poverty on the church. They will blame their poverty on the government. Lord, I pray you will forgive them. Forgive them. But now, Lord, I pray, because I have given them their word and they have believed the word, I pray you open the door. Open their eyes. Lord, they were moving without seeing what to do. Open their eyes. Show them what to do. Open their eyes. Show them the business they can do. Open their eyes. Show them where the job is hiding. Open their eyes. As they leave the church today, Lord, I pray by the divine power of the Holy Ghost, lead them, direct them, go with them, show them the way in the name of Jesus. Those who become obedient to this message, they will come back here and they will testify that my condition has changed.
Thank you, Lord,
because I know your
answer.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Give Jesus a big hand.
Yes, for him.